Johnson's Motor Car.
Bust down my Brannigan's corner, one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel, and to me he did say, we have orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar. But how are we to get there without a motor car?
Oh, well, Barney, dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what to do. The specials, they are plentiful, but the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranraer,
and we'll give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnson's motor car.
When Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his castor hat and on his breast a star.
You could hear the din all through the fin of Johnson's motor car.
But when he got to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there, old Johnson knew the game was up, but at him they did stare. He said, I have a permit to travel near or far.
To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car.
What will me loyal brethren say, oh, when they hear the news? Me car has been stolen by the rebels at Dunloo. We'll give you our receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr.
And when Ireland gets her freedom, why, you'll get your motor car. Well, they put that car in motion, and the builder to the brim, with guns and bayonets shining, which made old Johnson grim. And Barney hoisted the Sinn Féin flag, and it flutter like a star. And we gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnson's motor car.